What's up, YouTube? You checking out the Frequent Flyer, and this is the comparison, I guess you would say, of the LS-124 and the MJ-102. So it's the LS-124 versus the MJ-102, and really the purpose of this video is not really to put them up against each other, but to explain why I really like a slow yaw rate as opposed to a overly fast yaw rate. And these two quadcopters I can best demonstrate that with, because the LS-124 has a super speedy yaw rate, whereas the MJ-102 has a yaw rate which most seem to see as a slow yaw. But I think this yaw rate is a perfect yaw rate for me and my style of flying. So I'm going to just demonstrate why. We're going to fly both of the quadcopters on high rates. So we're going to start off with the MJ-102. Okay, so first, let's look at the yaw. This is the yaw of the MJ-102. So let's demonstrate how that benefits in fast forward flight. So basically, I think it's more, you can more control the quad. There's more control with the quad with a yaw at this speed when you're flying fast. Simply because you can bank well with the yaw. This yaw rate is perfect for a bank turn, in my opinion. You can slam on the air brakes with it on a turn and stop the quad from crashing into something. Of course, that will only be with fast forward flight. And I tend to fly fast with my quads a lot, especially outdoors. It's really kind of hard to demonstrate indoors, but that's the best I can do there with indoor flight. So let's land the MJ-102 now. See if we can rebind it. Okay, we're on high rates. Okay, now let's look at the yaw rates. This is the yaw rate on the LS-124. So a super fast yaw rate. Now the problem is, this is okay when you're flying around like this. It's doable. However, there's really no smooth flying with this thing with the yaw rate this fast on high rates. And I like my pitch rates to be high, but the yaw on this thing is insane. Like, this is about the fastest I can fly without without actually crashing this thing with the yaw rate being this fast. If I was to do any fast forward flight or anything and try to do a bank turn with this thing, it will result in a crash almost every time. So let me try it anyway, just for the sake of showing. Okay, so let's try it again. Go. So it's really fast, and it's hard to get control of it when you're flying that fast. Let me see. I think something's going on with the accelerometer now. Confused it a little. Let me get it leveled. Okay, it's level again now. So pretty impossible to do a bank turn with this thing when you're flying fast. Try one more time for the road. One more time for the road. So you can do one of those, a sliding turn, really quick, and just time it perfectly to stop it from spinning. But eventually, that's going to be your result. So I guess I've demonstrated enough of why I don't like an overly fast yaw rate as opposed to a slow yaw rate. So that's it. Thanks for watching.